I'm going to start my comments with some fact checked. Every fact check that I'm about to state is contained with the primary sources that I've emailed to the clerk, who can then distribute these facts to you. Fact check number one. This is maybe an opinion. Being trans is in no way comparable to the statutory rape by a teacher. Comparing the two stories is disgusting. Two, about who we voted on. Public comment in the 30-day period about Youngkin's model policy had 70,000 comments overwhelmingly against the Youngkin 2023 policy. Every anti-trans bill in the legislature in this session was defeated. We didn't vote for squat. There is no need to adopt a policy when we already have a policy in place that meets the requirements of the law. Children are not the property of the parent. To remove a book from access in a library is considered a ban as understood by the Supreme Court in 1982. Less than 3% of those who seek gender-affirming medical care actually detransition permanently. Less than 3%, that's a rate that's better than chemotherapy. That's a rate that is better than LASIK regret. No child can seek care without a parent, a therapist, and a doctor. So that weeds out the whole fad idea. And lastly, because I love to track money and sources, Speak Up Chesterfield is a project of the Family Foundation and their Speak Up Virginia group. It is a national dark money influence group. It's not a grassroots group. It's not a community group. Now, thank you for adopting the inclusive model policy that was discussed with community members, caregivers, and parents 2 years ago. Two, books are a parent's rights issue. That part is right. I do not co-parent with radical right-wing members of my community. Therefore, those members do not have a right to tell my kid what they can read. Because you disagree with it does not make it porn. Because it has accurate vernacular in the dialogue does not make it porn. Because it takes a real-world look at issues, that does not make it porn. Spotsylvania just banned a number of books, including The Handmaid's Tale, calling it porn. Sexually explicit is a plausible deniability phrase used to get the foot in the door to then go after books by and about members of the queer and BIPOC community. Do not lose sight of the fact that there is a nationwide coordinated effort to discredit our schools, sabotage our schools, get our teachers to quit, get our libraries
Thank
to quit.
Thank you, Mr. Carabinas.
All together.